كان أرجو له خيرا. نبي كريم صلى الله عليه وسلم began to smile. النبي كريم صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Okay, I have seen a face in which I sense خير, in which I sense good. What is behind you?" He says, "I asked Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Okay, what Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is referring to? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ya Abdul Rahman, you have been entrusted with something. Somebody has sent a message. Convey this message to me. My brother Himyari is from the special believers." Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, "This is when I declared, 'Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, there is no God worthy of worship, and truly Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah.'" And then he recited the couplets and informed Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of what Asqalan ibn Awakin al-Himdi said. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ki Rabbi mu'minun bi wa lam yarani wa musaddiqun bi wa ma shahidani ulaika ikhwani haqqa." Oh Allah, he believed in me yet he did not see me, and he declared his faith yet he did not see me. Oh Allah, they are my true brothers. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu was from amongst the Sabiqeen al-Awwaleen, the first people to embrace Islam. And he was out of the few that migrated to Habsha and migrated to Madinah al-Munawwara. When he migrated to Madinah al-Munawwara, he had nothing. He left everything behind in Makkah al-Mukarram, just like the other companions did. And when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made the Muhajireen, those that migrated, made the Muhajireen and Ansar, the Ansar, the residents of Medina, when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam created brotherhood between them, he made Abdul Rahman ibn Auf the brother of Sa'd ibn Rabi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now Sa'd ibn Rabi al-Ansari was one of the most wealthiest men of Medina. He received his brother very well. He said to him, "Ya Abdul Rahman, akhi, ana aktharu ahli al-Madinati malan, fanzur shatra mali fakhudhu wa tahti imra'atan, fanzur ayyatuhuma a'jaba ilayk hatta utalliqaha lak." He said to him, "Ya Abdul Rahman, I am the richest and wealthiest man in Medina. Half of my wealth is at your disposal. Do with it as you please. O Abdul Rahman, I have two wives. Look at them. Whichever pleases you, tell me. I will divorce her for you so that you can marry her after her period of waiting." Abdul Rahman radiallahu ta'ala replied, "Okay, my brother, barakallahu fi ahlika wa malika, dullani ala thuk." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with regards to your wealth, bless you with regards to your family. Just show me where the market is. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu was shown where the market was, and he began to trade and he made a little profit. He came back with some cheese and some ghee. Not long, and Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu is already married. He comes to the gathering of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with some saffron on his clothes. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks, "What's this?" Sayyidina Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu explained that he's just got married. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks, "Ya Abdul Rahman, how much dowry did you give?" He replied, "Okay, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I gave gold as much as a date seed." Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, "Oh Abdul Rahman, awlim walaw bishatin, give walima, celebrate this wedding even if you have to slaughter a goat." Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, "Okay, laqad ra'aytuni walaw rafa'tu hajran rajawtu an usiba tahtahu dhahaban aw fidda." He says, "I saw myself thereafter that even if I raised a stone, I would hope to find gold or silver underneath it." And this is exactly what had happened. From having nothing when he came to Madinah al-Munawwara, such became of Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The hadith recorded by Ahmad, narrated by Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says that whilst Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was in her house, all of a sudden Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha heard this loud noise. As our mother Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha asked the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in, "Okay, what's this?" The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in informed her, "Ki'irun li Abdul Rahman ibn Auf min al-Shami tahmilu min kulli shay," that a caravan belonging to Abdul Rahman ibn Auf has just arrived from Sham, 700 camels carrying all types of food. Thus the people came out to see, and there were a lot of noise. As Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhu then said, "Ki ra'aytu samitu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, ra'aytu Abdul Rahman ibn Auf yadkhulu al-jannata hawwan," that I heard Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that I saw Abdul Rahman ibn Auf crawl into paradise. When Abdul Rahman ibn Auf was informed of what our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, he said, "If I'm able to do so, then I'd rather enter paradise walking." And he donated every single thing in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was because of his wealth that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him in a dream. And I'm sure that you are aware that the dream of a prophet is also revelation. Abdullah ibn Abi Awfa radiallahu ta'ala anhu relates, "Okay, one occasion, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came upon his companions, and Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Kaya ashabu Muhammadin, Lakad arani Allahu al-laylata manazilakum fil jannati, wa qadra manazilakum min manzili. Oh, the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah showed me your positions and your homes in paradise, and how far they are from my home. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then turned to Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, and said, Kaya Ali, ala tarda, أن يكون منزلك مقابل منزلي في الجنة أو علي. Will it not please you that your house be opposite mine in paradise? He replied, okay, yes, O Messenger of Allah, be Abi wa Ummi, may my parents be sacrificed for you. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Sayyidina Ali, O Ali, your house is opposite mine. Then Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned to Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and said to Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, كَإِنِّي لَأَعْرِفُ رَجُلًا بِإِسْمِهِ وَإِسْمِ أَبِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ إِذَا أَتَى بَابَ الْجَنَّةِ لَمْ يَبْقَ مِنْ أَبْوَابِهَا وَلَا غُرْفَةٌ مِنْ غُرْفِهَا إِلَّا قَالَ لَهُ مَرْحَبًا مَرْحَبًا that I know a man by his name and the name of his mother and father, that when he comes to paradise, all the doors of paradise will be open for him and the wardens will call out, مَرْحَبًا مَرْحَبًا welcome, welcome. Sayyidina Salman said to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَيَا Allah, this man indeed will not be disappointed. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that this man is Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an. Thereafter Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned to Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala an. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ke Umar, I saw in paradise a palace mir'ar of a white pearl. It was beautiful and the beauty of this palace impressed me. I asked Ridwan, Ke ya Ridwan liman hadha al-qasr, who is this palace for? And Ridwan said, okay, this palace is for a young man from the Quraysh. فَظَنَنْتُهُ لِي I thought he was referring that it was for me. I went to enter. And when I tried to enter, I was told, يَا مُحَمَّدْ هَذَا لِأُمَرْ بْنِ الْخَطَّابِ This palace is for Umar Farooq رضي الله تعالى عنه. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, O Umar, فَلَوْلَا غَيْرَتُكَ لَدَخَلْتُ O Umar, had it not been for your ghairat, then I would have entered. Tears began to flow from Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu's eyes. And said Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu remarked, Ke, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would I have been sensitive with regards to yourself? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then turned to Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala anhu and said, Ke, Ya Uthman, inna kulli nabiyin rafiqan, inna likulli nabiyin rafiqan fil jannah, wa anta rafiqi fil jannah, that every prophet has a friend and companion in paradise, and you will be my friend and companion in paradise. Then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned to Sayyidina Zubair and Talha and said, every prophet has a disciple, you will be my disciples in paradise. Then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned to Abdurrahman ibn Auf and said, O Abdurrahman, you were delayed. You were delayed so much that I began to fear for you. And then when you finally came, you came in such a condition that you were full of sweat. And I asked you the reason for your delay. And O Abdurrahman, you explained that it was as a result of your wealth. And that you were giving hisab of your wealth. You were held account with regards to your wealth. You were asked with regards to where you had earned this wealth from and where you had spent it. Tears began to flow from Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu's eyes, and Sayyidina Abdurrahman radiallahu ta'ala anhu gave a big donation in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu had so much wealth that Talha ibn Abdurrahman ibn Auf replaced. Kana ahlul madinati ayalan ala Abdurrahman ibn Auf. Thuluthun yaqridhuhum malahu, wa thuluthun yaqdi daynahum bimali, wa thuluthun yasiluhum. That the whole of Medina were dependent on Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu. A third of them, he would loan money to them. And a third of them, he himself would pay off their loans. And a third of them, he would just give them money just like this. The following narration that I narrate to you will give you an idea of what Sayyidina Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu possessed. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu relates, okay, when Abdurrahman ibn Auf fell ill, fearing that he will not recover and he will die from this illness, he made wasiyah in a third of his wealth. He instructed where it should go. However, he later recovered. And when he recovered, he gave out this wealth with his own hands. He said, O companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all those that participated in Badr can have 400 dinars each. That one day he gave 150,000 dinar. And then at night he wrote on a piece of paper, ordering for all his wealth to be distributed between the muhajirin and ansar. حتى كتب أن قميصه الذي على بدني لفلان وأمامته لفلان ولم يترك شيء من ماله إلا كتبه للفقراء. All his wealth he wrote to be distributed between the muhajirin and ansar, to the extent that he wrote down that the shirt on his body should be given to so and so, and the amama and the turban on his head should be given to so and so. He did not leave anything. He had written it all for the poor. In the morning, he prays behind Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Jibra'il Amin descends from the heaven and says to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says, convey my salams to Abdurrahman ibn Auf and take the paper from him and then give it back to him and say, Allah has accepted his sadaqah and he is the deputy of Allah and his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and let him spend as he did before and there will be no hisab.